Sergeant Acton, please leave Quinnan.
If you want to come this way, we had to lock him up. He didn't seem too keen to wait for you lot.
Can you explain what happened?
He comes up the window and asks for two tickets to Birmingham. Handed over this cheque and his card. Except it wasn't his card. His signature was nothing like it.
You sure about that?
Yeah, no doubt at all. Through it.
Who spotted it?
One of me clerks, Tom. He didn't react at first, but mate, he was looking very nervous, you know. So Tom made up this excuse. He had to go and change the paper and the ticket printer. He called me and we ran round outside. The bloke tried to run for it, so I blocked his way. And he was shoving. Had a right go, he did. Anyway, we got him up here out of the way to customers. Is that me, Tom?
There's some mistakes all out of proportion now.
Right, what's your name?
Glenn Bishop.
Address?
Number 18 Tallow Street.
He threatened me! Kick me up them stairs, are you allowed to do that?
I was only defending myself. I thought he was going to get violent.
Yeah, we'll deal with that later. Were you trying to use these?
Well, yeah.
Well, the name on here is Arnold Wentworth.
He's a friend of mine. He said I could use them. I live with him and he said it'd be okay.
That doesn't make it okay.
So why were you trying to run away?
I don't know. I suppose he knew he'd never understand.
Okay, you're coming with us.
Right to Disneyland. They're doing a special offer.
I'm
oh, come on, it was
deception.
A favour for
you
Arnold.
You do not have to say anything.
What about him? He went
harm
for
your
me.
If you do not mention Wentworth.
Oh, come on, this is stupid.
You don't have to do this. Look, he's my landlord. He's an old man. He didn't get out much. He really wouldn't mind. Can we just forget about all this and just give me back to him?
No.
Oh, come on. No one's been murdered, Joe. Nothing. It's no big deal, really.
Shut up.
I wasn't talking to you.
Get in. What's he playing at?
I don't know. Let's find out, shall we? Sierra Oscar from 4-8, receiving over.
Go ahead, Serge.
Can you inform Sierra Oscar 1 that we're going to carry out a Section 18-5 search at Tallow Street?
Over.
4-8 from Sierra Oscar. All received.
There's nothing here.
Keys?
I must have forgotten them.
Is there anybody in?
I don't know. Vanessa.
Lynn, I told you.
And you are?
Vanessa Bishop, his wife.
Right, Mrs. Bishop, your husband is under arrest for deception. Is Arnold Wentworth here?
Arnold? Well, he's gone for the day, unexpected-like.
I want to search the house, Ness.
You can't come in here.
Oh, yes, we can. Thank you. That looks nasty. How did it happen?
Well, I was stuck in the shelf in the kitchen and it collapsed.
Did it now?
Blimey.
You all sleep in this room?
Well, we're a very close family.
So what about Arnold Wentworth?
In the other room.
He does live here.
That's his gas bill. What do you think?
Does anybody else live here? Right, we better get started.
Toys and stuff.
Luxurious.
Yeah, it was like this when we got you.
Racing papers. All of them. Nearly all.
That's Arnold's.
Obviously a man of leisure.
Likes a flat, doesn't
he? Yeah, he has the occasional bet.
Occasional. Uh-oh, can you smell that?
Told you I live with him.
What happened?
He had a heart attack last night.
You sure about that?
Yeah, he wasn't well. He had angina. His stuff written in the bathroom, the nifedipine. Well, I read the label.
Have you informed anyone?
No, not yet. We found him like us last night. We'd been out.
What didn't you think to call a doctor?
What for? He was dead.
Well, haven't they got coroners in Wales? Undertakers, that sort of thing.
Look, it's not that easy. We're new round here.
What are you doing here?
I told you, he's a friend. He was putting us up for a while. It was just a temporary thing.
Well, it was for him.
Right, take him downstairs, Dave. Sierra Oscar from 4-8 receiving.
Go ahead, Sarge.
18 Tallow Street. We need the FME for a sudden death.
Over.
A body? I thought they were looking for dodgy plastic.
A not-so-flexible friend.
What time did you find him?
About 9.
Where have you been?
What?
The supermarket. We've been to the supermarket.
Look, what is this? We're telling the truth. We haven't done anything.
Oh, that's the problem. You did nothing. Explain it to me. Why didn't you report it straight away?
I don't know. He was late. I mean, he's not going anywhere, is he?
Charming.
Look, that's enough. We're not criminals.
He was a friend of an aunt's. We were using the house as a base to look for work. We don't know anyone here. We're from Kidwelly, but Glenn lost his job.
When?
3 months now. I told you. He was putting us up till we found our feet.
Oh, so to repay his generosity, you decide not to report his death?
We didn't know. Well, it'd only been a few hours. We would have, you know.
Yeah, we know. Once you were safely halfway up the M6.
No. No!
In peth ar yn llath, Glenn. In peth ar yn llath.
When will it all stop, Sergeant?
FME's here, Sarge.
Right. Hello. Hi there, it's upstairs. Okay, Kirby, Dave will fill you in.
Right, Dave?
Magic. Through here. This lad, he's a prisoner.
Okay, I'll take him. Come on.
Well, what about us?
Well, we're going to need a full statement, but, well, we could do that here.
No, thanks. I want to stay with Glenn.
That won't be possible. He'll be in custody.
I don't care. We're not staying here.
It'll be more comfortable here for both of you.
I want to come.
What's going on here then, Dave?
Well, it starts off as a cheque fraud. Come back and do a search and find a stiff neatly tucked up in bed.
As you do.
Yeah. Well, let's leave the old man for somebody else to find. Let's have his wallet and away.
Nice.
Right. The FME says that all the signs indicate a heart attack. She's just finishing up now.
What about the time?
Yeah, fits in with their story.
Well, why didn't they declare it?
Point. I mean, I could sort of see a motive if they were planning to cash in and then live here rent-free, but they were obviously all set to leave.
Running away from something.
Look, take the panda back to Sunhill, run a PNC check, see what you can find.
Right, Sarge. I'll speak a bit of Welsh, you know.
I'm sure.
Bah!
Debbie, once the FME's finished, can you wait here for the undertakers? And then I'd like you to do some house-to-house inquiries, see if you can get any background about Wentworth. Go to the local surgery, you must have visited there recently. And you could try the bookies, now the nearest one's on...
Mayfield Street?
Right.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, thanks a lot. Yeah, I will. Yeah, that's great. Thanks. The PNCs were no trace and not wanted both of them. So I ranked Welly CID and that proved a bit more interesting.
Keen on this one, Dave.
What? Yeah. Anyway, I found a DS Thomas and he's quite familiar with Glenn Bishop. He might not have any form, but he's not quite the innocent he'd like us to believe.
Look, Vanessa, we simply want you to answer a few questions so that we can try and find out exactly what happened to Arnold Wentworth.
Well, yeah, I understand, but I think I told you everything in the house.
You said that Mr. Wentworth was a friend of an aunt's. Can you give us the aunt's name?
Well, she's dead now.
She's dead?
Yeah.
Dead Andy.
You know, he's not very nice.
Mummy, is the man coming back?
Beth and Dowell now. Gav Mummy, Charlotte.
Oh, no, I do Dean and Dodd now.
Zoe?
What?
What man?
Sorry.
Is what man coming back?
Well, she means Arnold. We told her he'd gone away on holiday. She liked him.
Mrs. Bishop, Glenn was a dispenser in a pharmacy back in Wales, right?
Yeah.
So why did he lose his job?
Well, he was made redundant. What's that got to do with this?
After he was accused of stealing a Class A drug.
Rubbish! His boss only made that up because Glenn found him using false prescription notes. And he knew Glenn wouldn't let that go because Glenn's straight as a die. Glenn wasn't even charged.
A lack of evidence, wasn't it?
No. No evidence. I suppose that prat Thomas told you this. He thought it was him who spread the rumours. I don't have to stay here, do I? You can't make me do this.
No, but it would make life easier.
I've got nothing more to say. We'll be waiting in reception for Glenn. Come on. The result you wanted?
I thought it was the right moment.
Yeah, well, it wasn't, was it? And next time you want to wade in, you clear it with me first.
Oh, come on, Sarge, you're not buying all that nonsense, are you?
She could have been telling the truth. You shouldn't let your personal feelings cloud your judgment, Dave.
I don't think I am. Are you?
Down, won't you?
Yeah, cool.
Is this about Arnold?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I'm old, I'm not blind.
Oh, did you know Arnold Wentworth then?
I only knew him to say hello to. That wasn't always wise.
What do you mean?
Perhaps you'd like to come in. I'm not too good on my legs for long.
Come on. We're going to have a little chat. Oh, by the way, dear Thomas sends his regards. Said to say hello to Mr. Methodite.
That's not funny.
I'm not laughing.
That's why we had to leave Kidwelly. And next time you chat to that tosser Thomas, you ask him where he learned to add up, because 2 and 2 don't make 17.
Dave?
Glenn was just telling me how trouble seems to follow him around.
I saw him last night when I was putting the milk bottles out. He was drunk, not for the first time. He said he was celebrating a big win on the horses, so I let him off. He asked me to let him in. Being very vulgar, he was. And I mean, I'm 68. Said he didn't care. He'd be my toy boy. He wasn't very gentlemanly.
Right, Glenn, perhaps you'd like to tell us how long you've been a friend of Arnold Wentworth's.
A long time. Yeah, he was a friend of my father's.
And that's how you knew him?
Yeah, they were both in the army together.
Not a friend of your aunt's, then?
I'm not very good at this, am I?
He wasn't a friend of yours at all, was he?
Not at first, no. Well, when we arrived here, we got some tiny poxy DSS bed set, sharing a bathroom with 6 others. It wasn't nice. We met Arnold in the street a few times. We used to help him out, doing his shopping and stuff. Occasionally Vanessa would cook him a meal.
But why did you move in?
Well, he suggested it a few weeks back. I mean, we both benefited. He had some company and someone to share the bills with. We had some space and access to a bathroom that didn't stink of piss.
But why didn't you tell us all this at the house?
Because I knew it sounded so damn suspicious. You turning up, him dead, who the hell were we? You're right, I should have told you.
You're obviously a decent sort of chap, aren't you, Glenn?
Is he having me on or what?
No, I mean it. There you are, looking out for this old man. Trying to do what's best for your wife and kid in difficult circumstances. And of course you're so principled that you leave a perfectly decent job in Kidwelly.
Right.
Right. So what I don't understand is that a nice chap like you wouldn't call the ambulance when they find a friend of theirs unconscious.
He was dead.
Exactly, exactly. Why would a concerned citizen like you steal a dead man's money and leave his body there to rot?
Because
you're not telling us everything, are you, Glenn?
Oh, you think you're really perceptive, don't you, Constable? You should be in CID.
Just tell us what happened.
There was a bloke.
What?
He turned up about 5 o'clock yesterday. When Arnold was out, a big bloke.
Did he give a name?
No, he just barged in when Vanessa opened the door. Started knocking things over, the telly and stuff. Then he demanded money. Said he knew Arnold had won some money recently. We told him Arnold wasn't in, but then he started hitting Vanessa. Said if the old man couldn't pay up, we would have to.
Why didn't you mention all this before?
Because we didn't want to get involved. This has nothing to do with us. We just wanted to get away from all this.
4 units from Sierra Oscar, rear of 18 Tallow Street, possible burglary.
Then unit deal.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra 1, we can take it, Sarge.
You just came from there?
Yeah. Sierra 1 from 4-8. Be careful, you may be dealing with a violent character.
Tell her not to worry. I'll send you in first.
Where did that come from, Jim?
Glenn Bishop's interview.
Oh, come on. Mysterious, unnamed men turning up with threats of violence. Must be the way he tells them.
What, so this break-in is what, coincidence?
Well, why not? A neighbour sees all the activity, knows the house is empty. He's had a good few hours in the cell. Enough time to dream up some Jack and Nori, a good one, I grant you.
Why would he make all that up? Where does it get him?
Out the spotlight. Throw the attention up to somebody else. Because I still don't believe he's telling us the truth.
Excuse me. Sergeant Cryer.
Good evening, officers.
The hell do you think you're doing?
I take it you've come to arrest me.
Do you live here?
No.
Then yes, I am.
Right, should we discuss this at the station?
I'll sit in when you interview him, if that's okay, Tony.
I might sell tickets for this one.
Can someone get that? Well?
I believe it. Yes? Debbie? Yes, we've got him in custody. She is. Can you hang on? June, it's for you.
Hey?
Debbie.
Whose is this?
Belongs to Stuart Bates.
Hello?
Hello, Sarge. It's Debbie Keane. From the manager of the bookies in Nayfield Street. Neil Larkin. He claims that Wentworth owed him £3,000 for some time, so he hired an assistant to collect the debt. Sarge? Hello? Yeah, that's better. No, he's freelance. Bit of a reputation, apparently. Calls himself Debt No More, and the only contact is mobile. No. Except he did get a tip-off that Wentworth had scored a big win at another bookies on Tarwin Road yesterday. Several thousand, apparently.
Right. Debbie? Hey, Debbie? Bob.
Thank you.
561 from 4-8. Debbie, just get back here as soon as you can. Over.
All right.
Dave, when Debbie comes back, have a word with her. Apparently Wentworth won a good few grand yesterday. Bates is Wentworth's bookie's debt collector, hired by him. I'm sorry, but it looks like you were wrong on this one.
Hold on. The old man wins a mint. Next day he's found dead. Glenn, the drugs expert, is on his way out. What do you think?
Well, I think that a couple with a young child and no previous offences were probably scared witless by a thug with a history of assault.
Makes sense to me, Dave.
Right, let's go and interview Bates, shall we?
Touch.
Right, you claim to be a friend of Wentworth's. When were you last at his house?
Not for some time, a few months.
An officer rang your phone, having been given the number by somebody who claimed to have hired you as a debt collector. Now, I'm asking you one more time, when were you last at Wentworth's house?
Okay, hang on. This isn't about me, is it? What are you doing here? You didn't arrest me.
Arnold Wentworth was found dead in his house today.
Right, this has nothing to do with me. I was home last night with my girlfriend.
We'll check that out.
Please do. I'm legit, I'm a businessman. I don't go in for rough and tumble anymore, not since Longmarsh. I'm still on parole.
Oh, I remember that.
The last time I was at Tallow Street was about 2 weeks ago and he wasn't even there.
So what happened?
A woman answered. Never seen her before. She let me in, but Wentworth was out. I told him he owed me a lot of money and that I'd be back and to make sure he had it. That was it. I left.
So why did you break in today?
I heard Wentworth had a major win, a good few grand on an accumulator. I went round there, but there was no answer. Well, that sort of thing happens in this business, you know?
Yeah, I understand you've got a bit of a reputation.
Yeah, and that's all it is now, a reputation. A stint inside for GBH does wonders. Depending on your point of view.
Debbie, what you got?
Where's Sergeant Ackland?
Interviewing your debt collector. So, do you get anything on Wentworth?
Not much. Only that he's a drunken, gambling, lecherous old sod.
Popular, then?
Especially with his neighbours. One of them met him last night after the pubs had closed. Said he could hardly keep his hands to himself.
Hang on. So he was seen in the street after chucking out time?
Yeah, why?
Because it's a lot later than 9 o'clock. Sarge.
Dave. Bates has got an alibi. He says he was with his girlfriend last night at home.
Really? And we got a neighbour who saw Wentworth in the street around 11:30 last night.
Really?
He was out in the Razzle celebrating his big win.
An hour and a half after they claimed they found him dead. They've both been lying all along.
Right, come on.
Where's Glenn?
We haven't released him yet. It's you we need to talk to now.
But I've told you everything.
I don't think you have, Vanessa.
What else? What's Glenn said?
Look, I'd like to take you into one of our interview rooms where I can tape our conversation.
What for? I haven't done anything.
And I think it might be an idea if Zoe went with WPC Keane for a while.
No! This isn't fair.
Should be fine. I'll take you to the soft interview room, yeah?
Yeah.
The what?
It's a room specially for children.
So you go and play with a nice lady for a while, is it? Is that okay? This isn't fair. She's only a little girl.
Look, there's no need to get upset. She'll be back. We only want to talk to you.
I've told you everything I know.
We have information that contradicts your story, Vanessa.
Why, what's he said?
Who?
Glenn. He didn't do anything.
Come on.
No! Glenn said it would all be all right. He promised.
Promise what?
That this wouldn't happen. I've had enough. I've just had enough.
Look, talk to me, Vanessa.
No! This is so unfair. I didn't kill him. He was all over me. He was drunk and trying to kiss me. It was horrible. I was trying to get him off and he started hitting me. Going on about all he'd done for us and didn't I owe him something? I didn't think this was going to happen. I just pushed him off. He fell, started shaking. We tried to help him. This is all so unfair.
Yes, it probably is.